An Iranian scientist says that he's created a time machine. Whoop, whoop, whoops. The tiny invisible bullshit detector I invented is going crazy. I don't know why. I'm Anthony, and yes, Ali Razeghi, a scientist at the Iranian Center for Strategic Innovations, has created a device he calls the Arayak Time Machine. You touch it, and it predicts the next 5 to 8 years of your life with 98% accuracy. Prints your future out, right on paper. He just can't show it to anyone or explain how it works right now. I told my totally real girlfriend who lives in Niagara Falls and is a supermodel about this, and she was like, so he's lying and he named it wrong? Because that's not actually a time machine. Then she tried to make out with me, again. But this brings up some really great questions. Is there any way for us to actually see the future? And will we ever be able to travel through time? So, as of right now, we've got no clue how we'd see into the future. Bright side, we already have the ability to see into the past. We actually do it all the time. See, light travels at 186,000 miles per second, right? And the farther something is from us, the longer it takes the light from it to get here. And that's where the term light years comes from. It takes light from the North Star 430 years to get to us. So when you look up at the North Star, you're seeing it as it was 430 years ago. If you could create an insanely huge telescope and take a look at the Curiosity rover on the surface of Mars, you'd see everything it was doing 3 minutes ago. Even looking at this screen right in front of you, taking into account the speed of light and your brain's processing time, you're seeing something 300ths of a second old. You're always looking into the past. You can't help it. Traveling through time, as opposed to seeing through time, that's a different story. We're all actually traveling through time right now, at the speed of 1 hour per hour. Not super exciting, I know. But there is a way to slow that down. The closer an object moves to the speed of light, the slower time moves for that object. This happens on a really small scale for astronauts. So the space shuttle takes off at 17,500 miles an hour. And when the astronaut comes back, they're a millisecond younger than they would have been if they had stayed home. If you could travel 500 light years away from Earth and then back at 99.95% of the speed of light, you would land 1,000 years in the future and it would have been only 10 years for you. Great, let's do it, hook it up. Well, here's the issue. Einstein's theory of special relativity. See, the faster an object moves, the more mass it has. The more mass it has, the more energy it takes to move. So traveling at the speed of light would take infinite energy. And as impossible as that sounds, getting back from the future or traveling into the past, that's even more insane. We are talking about sci-fi stuff like wormholes and cosmic strings and space-time curvatures and all sorts of things that may not exist. And if they do exist, they would either destroy you or a galaxy when you tried to poke at them. Stephen Hawking had this theory called chronology projection conjecture. It basically means that the laws of physics will not allow anyone to go back in time. He thinks that no matter how close we come, some new obstacle is always gonna pop up to keep us from doing it. Anyone else have a headache? Short version, we can see the past, we can travel to the future, and we cannot switch that up. At least, not yet. And probably not with a box some guy refuses to demonstrate for anyone. But let's say we made it happen. Where would you go? The future or the past? I would go future because, number one, there are too many diseases in the past and not enough hoverboards. Let me know down below and subscribe for more D News.